Hello friends, I am Gautam Anand. Today I will discuss over the LTE, what happens after UE switched on in LTE. So we will discuss over this, and so there is some process here when after power on UE, first it's go for the frequency search and scan the entire frequency band. And after the serial search, we'll search PSS. Normally you would find a multiple signal in this process, and SSS reference signal used. After that reference signal, UE specific, serial specific, cell selection, MIP decoding, SIP decoding. After that RAG process is happened. So we'll discuss one by one everything. So power on UE, you know that UE just power, UE has power, UE powered on. And after that is go for the frequency search, scan the entire frequency band. So one question is came here: when UE switch on, what is the first things happened? What is the first things? Yeah, it will search the frequency, but from where? How it will sync with the band? Where it will go? Because you don't know which frequency is there, which cell is there, you don't know. First UE powered on, what happens? As a default, UE will try to camp on 1.4 megahertz, but you know that in every RE they have some power. So which power is need for the UE? Then because of that it go for the sync on bandwidth. So as a default, I have told that as a default, by default they have some configuration in UE, and it's some configure with the 1.4 megahertz as a default. So if just see these pictures here, what happens? There is 72 subcarrier is there, 62. Actually it is the, if we are camping with the 1.4 megahertz, that means 6 resource block will be used. 6 resource block means 72 subcarrier. One resource block contain 12 subcarrier, and 6 resource block contain 72 subcarrier will be used. So above 5, this 5 will be used for the DTX, and lower 5 will be DTX. A remaining 62 will use as a subcarrier for the synchronization purpose. So actually for both FDD and TDD, they have the broadcast synchronization signal in downlink direction. This synchronization signal is primary synchronization signal and secondary synchronization signal. So you can see here, just there is a primary synchronization signal and secondary synchronization, but how UE will read from here? It will go for the read. So actually first when UE camp, when UE power on, then it will first try to the center frequency. Why center frequency? Just I want to show another picture. In these pictures you can see there are 5 here, subcarrier is used as a reserve. Already have told that it is used for the DTX. Here you can see it is used for the DTX, and the remaining 62, 31 subcarrier and 31 subcarrier is used for the primary and secondary synchronization signal. It is a synchronization signal, but this is a central frequency because you uses the synchronization signal in TDD, FDD at the same purpose. In TDD they have achieved the radio frame, subframe, slot, symbol synchronization in time domain, and FDD identify the center of channel bandwidth in the frequency domain. Center of the channel bandwidth, you use the synchronization to deduce the physical layer cell identity, and also they have the some condition is detecting the synchronization signal is a prerequisite to measuring the cell as specific reference signal and decoding the MIB on physical broadcast channel. So that is the different thing. So here first I will discuss over the DC, how UE will go to synchronize with the DC. This is a direct current, there is no power is need to sync with the DC. because DC subcarrier contain no information in LT. This correspond to the mapping onto middle mapping onto the middle of the 62 subcarriers within an OFDM sample resources grid. DC stands for the direct current, and it is a subcarrier that has no information sent on in. There is no information on central subcarrier. So you can see here, this is a direct current. There is no subcarrier on this. There is no power need to sync with the DC subcarrier. It is used by the mobile device to locate the center of air OFDM frequency band. So there is some UIS configuration is there, implementation is there. So it's used this device to locate the center of OFDM frequency band. Some formula is implemented in UE. UE has its contained formula has two part. First part is included the definition of all subcarrier that have a frequency below the center frequency. Below the center frequency, there is a two part. First part is below the center frequency, and one is the above the center frequency. And second part contains the definition for all subcarrier that frequency above the center frequency. So it is divided in two part. Below the DC and above the DC, and DC have no subcarrier information. There is no need to power. It is a direct current, direct carriers. Central frequency is the DC subcarrier, and DC subcarrier that mobile device used to help find the LT frequency. So this is the use of the DC carrier that the mobile device used to find the LT frequency. For the LT frequency, to find the exact LT frequency, it's to go to the DC subcarrier and try to the search the LT frequencies. And after that, what happened? DC subcarrier is a subcarrier whose frequency is equal to the RF center frequency of the transmitting station. It correspond to the frequency zero. You can say that it is frequency zero, direct current. A direct current, there is no need the frequency, there is no need. So because of that, if FFT signal is not modulated in DC subcarrier, DC subcarrier has the information, no information sent on it, and DC subcarrier is not transmitted, but is a counted in a number of subcarrier. It's used by the mobile device to locate the center of OFDM frequency band. If frequency domain, the PSA and SSS occupy the control 6 RBs, the synchronization sequence use 62 subcarrier in total with 31 subcarrier mapped on each side of the DC subcarrier. So now you can understand these pictures, whatever I have told you. When you will about that, this 5 is used for the DTX. DTX is applied to help to improve the quality of received reference signal. Above and below DTX will be used to help to improve the quality of the received reference signal, and remaining 62 will use 62. It's divided in two part. First part above the DC, this is the DC, above 31 is the DC, and below 31 of the DC. So there is 31 subcarrier as divided in two part, and so this is the basic design of what happens after the UE switch on. So how it's synchronized to the DC subcarrier. So this is the point. After that, we will see here primary synchronization and secondary synchronization. So friend, so from the next video tutorial, I will explain about the primary synchronization and secondary synchronization, how primary and secondary synchronizations detect the physical cell ID, and that physical cell ID is used to decode the reference signal. So these things will be discussed on next video tutorial. So thanks for watching this video. Bye, take care.